go.
Hello and welcome to Live at the Art Center Visual Arts Edition. This programming is just one of the ways we are looking to fulfill our mission and spread the arts to our community. Today I'll be leading you in an art demo working with Polymer Clip. If you're interested in seeing some of our previous videos from this series, please take a look back on our Facebook page on our website. I am Holland Borwick, and I am 11 years old, and we are making a teddy bear. You don't have to use clay. You can also use Play-Doh or silly putty. I'm using polymer clay. All right.
That'll focus on your hand.
Now, all right. First, you have to choose the color you want this to be. I am going to be peach color. You pinch off a bit of clay and then you knead it to get it softer. All right. Once it's kneaded, you roll it.
I can move this out of the way a little bit.
Ball. About size of marble.
There you go. You might need to speak up a little bit with cars.
All right. You can get the nose like a tent kind of thing. And round it a little bit at the end. Like this. Now, get some black clay. Make the eyes and nose. Roll it, stick it on, and roll it, stick it on, and you put the nose on this, that. Now, you can pinch off some more clay, a little bit more than for the head. Knead it. Now roll it into an oval shape. Stick it under the head for the body. Like that. Alright, then you can make the arms and legs. Alright. Ears. Make a weeny, weeny, weeny bit of clay in a ball and flatten it. That then, you can kind of bend it a little. Put one of the bent parts on its head like this and the other part sticking up. Do the same thing for the other ear. The arms. Just make it a little probably thicker. Line at the ends. And you can stick it kind of like it's sitting in a crisscross position ish. Like that. And do the other one. Roll it in a log, flatten it, and wrap it around like that. fun part. You get to make the bow tie on its little chin. You can also make like a little heart that it can be holding. That little guy.
The heart fell off. Or you can just, you know, leave it blank.
Alright. I'm going to take a little bit of pink for this. Alright. You can do red or orange or color you want. Alright. You pinch off just a weeny bit of clay. Now, you roll it into like a snake shape like this. Then you wrap it around to like a teardrop shape. Stick it under here. You can do the same thing for this side. Wrap it around and stick it. Alright. Then you do the same thing, but you make the two little snakes, but you make them a little shorter and you flatten them. That. And put them underneath these top of the bow. Roll it. Flatten it, stick it, and there is your ball. Now all you have to do, if you have polymer clay, you can bake it in the oven for at 265 degrees Fahrenheit for about 5 minutes, and then it's going to
go. So does it harden whenever you put it in the oven?
You put it in the oven, and when you take it out, it's a little soft, but when you let it cool, it hardens when it cools.
Nice. And how did you get into working with clay?
Well, my friend Nancy Kaiser, I saw her make, you know, Waffle House model of a Waffle House, and I wanted to know what she made out of, and she told me it was polymer clay. So I got some, and I got this book about how to do polymer clay things. I made a little dollhouse of polymer clay.
Very nice.
Dollhouse miniatures with polymer clay.
Nice. So that's a good resource if you're interested in getting into it. Mm-hmm. And how long have you been doing artsy things?
About like 3. Doing polymer clay for about a year. So maybe 6 months.
Do you ever build things that are bigger than the miniatures? Can you share some of your other examples and maybe talk about how you built those?
So this is a little basket of fruit, some pears and oranges. For like the basket, you take two snakes and you twist them together. You do that a lot of times. And for the bottom, you just have normal clay. Same thing for the handles. For the little cake, you can roll it in a ball and kind of flatten it. You can cut a little slice out of it and put it on a little plate. That. And like for a kitty, you can kind of do the same thing as a teddy bear, but do it lying flat. It's a little mousey. Just chasing it. This bear, he was holding it hard, but the heart fell off. So
what's the smallest thing you've ever made?
His arm fell off. Probably the mouse. I also made a little doll.
That is tiny.
Yeah. It's so hard to do its little eyes. This much clay. I also make little finger puppets for your finger.
Do you make those out of the clay too?
Yeah,
make them out of the clay. Very
nice. Some piggies and stuff.
Awesome.
I like making little
nice. So do you make a lot of the polymer clay stuff for your dollhouse, or?
Yeah, I just make it, like, for presents or pretty much anything, because I pretty much finished the dollhouse, so make it for, you know, selling or Christmas, birthdays.
Very nice. Awesome. Then do you have anything else that you want to say?
Very
uninteresting
person.
Right. Plenty of people disagree, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. Some of your more unusual things.
Churns,
butter churns.
Wow.
Little basket of potatoes. Little twist design.
Interesting.
We have the little pedophores, the cake Samantha has in the American Girl doll book. Basket of carrots.
Very nice.
Green tinge at the top. You make that with some pastels.
So can you paint the
yeah.
polymer clay whenever you're done? Do you have to paint it before or after the oven?
You probably should paint it after you put it in the oven. So it'll probably crack in the oven.
Hmm.
Fall off or melt or something.
Probably a good idea.
Except for, you know, like a palette. It'd be like a true palette.
Hmm. Interesting. Well then, I guess if you don't have anything else to add, can you read this outro here to kind of talk about?
Take some time today or this week to create your own piece of art inspired by this project to display in your yard. Or, you know, it doesn't have to be in your yard. Take a picture and send it up to us to be featured on our page as well. To get updates on our next live stream, follow us on Facebook. Thank you for joining us.